Hi, I'm John Edwards. Over the past four decades, the Department of Parks and Wildlife, West Australia's primary conservation agency, has seen a steady increase of southern right and humpback whale populations following the end of commercial whaling. With more whales, naturally, there's going to be greater potential for whale carcasses to wash ashore in populated areas. Decaying carcasses compose a number of public health and safety issues, so it's necessary to remove them. In this video, I'll take you through a safe and efficient method of whale carcass removal, which has been developed over many years of experience. The video features a successful example of a carcass removal conducted by the department using local contractors in the southwest. Please remember, while it's important to carry out any removal operation as efficiently as possible, we always have time to do our jobs safely. So if we look at the equipment you're going to need to do the job, we'll start with our personal protective equipment or our PPE. Starting at the bottom, good quality rubber boots, Wellington boots, if you can with steel caps. Disposable overalls, these also have a hood involved, so it'll cover you from bottom to top. We should also be wearing latex gloves at all times. With the biological matter that we're handling, these should be on at all times. You can wear them underneath riggers gloves and things for when you're working with ropes and chains, but they should be on at all times. Make sure everybody's got them on. For face protection from splashback, if that was to occur, safety glasses and face masks. May seem a little bit over the top, but I can promise you, not only does the whale smell bad, but it doesn't taste real good either. So make sure people are wearing these. Here we've got a tarp that will lay inside our cargo net, just again to contain some bodily fluids. We've got some lengths of 8mm silver rope. These are going to be used in combination with our cable ties to actually bind up nets. So if we don't have a net that's long enough to do the whole job, we can use smaller cargo nets and connect them all up using cable ties and rope. Make sure, a simple thing, but make sure you've got a knife to go with it as well. These webbing binders, these are 2.5 ton ratchet binders, available from pretty much any hardware store around the place. The number of these that you're going to need is going to depend on the size of the whale, as with all of the equipment that we've got here. Smaller whales, you're going to need less gear. Larger whales, you're going to need more gear. But make sure you've got a good supply of these 2.5 ton webbing binders. They'll be used to wrap around our cargo net. In this case, we're using, these are 3 metre square nets. It's good quality cargo net, and we'll be using our silver and our cable ties to join these together so we can do the job that we need to do. All of the gear that you see laid out here in front of you should be regarded as disposable. Once the whale's wrapped up and removed to the disposal site, all of this gear should go with it and stay with it. So the first process that we get into before we lay the net out is we've got to put our webbing binder straps under the net so that they can be the last thing that are tensioned up as part of the process. So if you're looking at, say, an 8 to 9 metre whale in front of us, you probably need at least 3 binders going across the width of the animal, and we'll need another couple of binders that go across the length of the animal. So for this purpose of demonstration, we'll just roll out a couple of binders and then we'll put some nets over the top. So Mies, if you just want to roll that binder out, that looks pretty good. Don't forget, you're going to have the whale on the downward side of you, so that you'll be actually rolling the whale up into the net. So basically, we want to have the net set so that when we roll the whale up, the whale essentially is either on its belly or its back. Ventral or dorsal sides provide the most stability for the animal. Given we've got a bit of a slope here, we don't want it rolling back onto the people that we're going to be working with. So we'll roll the net out, pull it down, and what we want is an overlap on either end of the animal. We just pull the net up so that we've got a bit of overlap on the tail side. Obviously our net's not going to be long enough in this case, so we'll grab a second net out and we'll show you how to connect them up. So we'll run this one down. So we've got it level with our other net. As you can see, it's good heavy cargo net. These are 3 metre squares. And basically, if that's all you've got, you can join as many of these together as you like to get the length and the width. But you can also get the nets made up to suit. We've got one net that's made up that's 10 metres by 8 metres. So as you can see, we've got our two nets up close together using our cable ties. We just bind them together. Try and make sure you've got a couple of cable ties in each net square, just to give you an idea how much strength you've got. You can never use too many. If you think you've got a weak spot, whack a cable tie through it. Try and make sure that the cable ties that you do get are a good quality. What we found is some of the ones that you can get from the local hardware store aren't quite as good a quality as those that you can get from, say, an automotive store. Much heavier duty, designed for longer life. They're the ones you want. You only want to have to do this once. All right, so we've got plenty of cable ties there. We're going to supplement that with some 8mm silver rope. This is just going to provide an extra bit of strength. And what we're going to do is leave long tags out either end so that we can use these to help tie up once we wrap the whole process around the animal. It's worth taking your time with this process to make sure you get it right. There's going to be a lot of stress on these joins once we start lifting the animal. So even for a small whale, you can see we've got 2 3-metre net sections set out here. Even for a small whale that you're looking at, 8 metres, I'd suggest you're going to need another 3 metre length on one end and then another 3 sections across the top as well. So you'll have a number of joins that you need to do this process for. It's time consuming, takes a little while, but if you do it right, then the end result's going to be a good one. So make sure you've got plenty of rope tags out either end and just leave those long. And then what you've got to do is make sure that you've got your webbing straps in the positions that you want them. If the tail of our animal is here, you might just need to adjust the length of where you've got the webbing strap so you can just move those along, backwards and forwards, to get them where you need them. So for demonstration purposes, we've got the webbing strap in the right spot, and we try and put the webbing straps evenly as placed as possible to make sure that we've got them under the heavy sections of the animal. So once you're happy with the positioning, you're ready to go. Now, in addition to this, for smaller whales, we can wrap the whole thing up. We might have 2 webbing straps that go the length of the nets as well, so that we can take those up and around the animal. However, if we're dealing with larger animals, you're not going to get the length, so we just have those ready to go. And once we've pulled the net up around the whale, girth-wise, pull the flaps up either end lengthwise, and we just tension across the top with 2 more binders. So from here on, we're pretty all ready to roll our whale up into the webbing sling. You see here, we've also got tarps. Now, if the animal is oozing a lot of material, then you can lay the tarp out now over the top of the whole cargo net. And basically, that becomes a bit of a protective barrier for fluids leaching out onto the beach. Now, if you've got a tarp that'll cover the whole animal, this one would certainly cover most of our 8 metre whale, then you only need the one. Larger animals, you're going to need more tarps. But make sure when you lay them out, start from either end and work into the centre so that your centre ones are laid over the top. And make sure you've got at least a 2 metre overlay so that when the whole thing's tensioned up, you've got some chance of capturing all those fluids. The fresher the animal, the less fluids you're going to have.
In 2016, a 35-tonne humpback whale carcass washed up near Moses Rock on Honeycombs Beach in the Nari Capes Marine Park. The carcass, measuring 12.5 metres, was safely and efficiently removed from this popular southwest surfing beach. The first thing we do is assess the carcass and the site to do some pre-planning. We look at what possible difficulties we may have, including the animal's proximity to the waterline, the slope and firmness of the beach, as well as our exit point off the beach. With this in mind, we can make an assessment on what type of machinery we might need. The secret of success with any carcass removal is to go big with your machinery right from the start. We can see the carcass, which has been dead for up to a week, rolling around in the shallows. With the surf quite heavy and the tide coming in, we want to get it up onto the sand as soon as possible. When large whale carcasses come ashore, they can draw a crowd. The public is naturally curious and want to see how the carcass is dealt with. On this occasion, there were only a few people watching on, but when there are larger numbers, it provides a great educational opportunity. Once the removal process starts, our priority is to keep everyone safe and away from the machinery and the decomposing carcass. Now we're discussing the best way to get the whale out of the water with the machinery contractors. The key with any whale carcass removal is clear communication. We know about the marine environment and the animal itself, but the contractors have the expertise in using their machinery. Once there's a plan in place, we brief all involved. Every carcass removal operation is different according to the location, whale size, decomposition, weather conditions, and other factors. The variables around the whale may change, but the process doesn't. For this removal, we have local contractors with a fair bit of experience, having done a few removals with the Blackwood District in the past. Steve has an excavator, a track excavator, and a small posi track available, as well as a low loader to transport the carcass to the waste facility. First, we need to get the whale out of the water, and the excavator is going to be used to roll it out. As you can see, the whale is not a solid object and has a tendency to roll back. The weight and fluidity of the carcass make it a difficult process. The machine operator has to get the animal up the beach without perforating or damaging the integrity of the carcass. A second machine gets in behind to push while the excavator pulls, and eventually we get the animal rolled up onto solid ground. This part of the operation has taken about an hour. With a larger machine, we may have got it done in a shorter period of time. But the main thing is, we've got the carcass out of the water and it's still intact. Having rolled at 360 degrees, there are fluids leaching out of the carcass. This can't be avoided, but it does reinforce the need to wrap it up well so that it doesn't break into pieces and become a much larger and messier job. The posi track has levelled out the landward side of the carcass, so we can now lay out the straps and nets. It's very important that we take our time with this part of the process, positioning the binding straps at key points, overlapping the nets, and then binding them together with cable ties and also silver rope to strengthen the joins. It's not a job you want to do a second time, especially after the material has been wrapped around a dead animal. We lay the tarpaulins over the top to contain fluids and entrails and attach them to nets with more cable ties. Cable ties may snap once you are tensioning up, but that's okay. They just need to hold things in place until you've wrapped it around the carcass. At this point, we all get our personal protective gear on. Safety is paramount in a job like this, and we don't want to come into direct contact with the decomposing material or the machines when they're moving around the animal. The machines work together, pulling and pushing the carcass into the nets. We need to be careful to retain the long ends of the ropes so that we can use them for tying up the nets. Once the animal is in place, pull up the sides of the nets and bind the edges with the ropes. Careful use of the machines can assist with tensioning the wrap. Then it's a case of tensioning and retensioning the nets with the binding straps so it's all secure. We weave the binding straps through the net lengthwise and check and cross-check the integrity of the net. Now we'll look at getting the whale from the beach landing up to the exit point off the beach. We have a 50-ton towing strap wrapped around the whale's peduncle and interwoven through the cargo net to spread the load as much as possible. This is now attached to the excavator. The carcass can be dragged, with the assistance of the other machine pushing it from the head end, up the beach to the exit point. There should be no debris left on the beach if the carcass has been well wrapped. Meanwhile, the posi track has been digging out some of the sand from the dune and creating a ramp. This sand will be replaced and the dune system rehabilitated once the whale is off the beach. The car park area has also been prepared with sand on the surface to protect it from the large machinery. This alone can significantly reduce any remediation costs that you might incur. Look at your access point and use any naturally existing landform to assist in loading the animal. As you can see, in this case, we used the slope of the dune to help us get the whale onto the low loader. More often than not, we would need a large crane to lift the carcass up onto the low loader or a tipper. With the excavator in the car park, we're able to use the bucket to lift the tail while the carcass is pushed onto the loader. The skill of the machine operators in this process is obvious to see. Once it is safely onto the low loader, it can be driven to the waste facility. Sometimes roads have to be closed, and we often work with Main Roads WA and local governments to facilitate this.
Successful whale carcass removals are achieved by good preparation and teamwork. It's about cooperation between state and local governments and other stakeholders who are all providing an important service to the community. In addition to this video, Parks and Wildlife publishes a whale carcass management brochure on its website. And if a whale carcass washes up on one of your beaches, the department can be contacted by phone for advice.